Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on CAPM, that is the Capital Asset Pricing Model, beta, that's what we are going to learn. We'll be learning definition, formulas and how it is calculated on the Excel. So, when we invest in stock market, how do we get to know that stock A is less risky than stock B? What is the case? What is the reason? Difference can arise due to the market capitalization, revenue size, growth management, etc. So can we find a single measure which tells us which stock is more risky? The answer is yes. And we call that as CAPM, that is the Capital Asset Pricing Model, Asset Pricing Model Beta, or Capital Asset Pricing Beta, Pricing Model Beta, you can say. In this tutorial, we are going to look at a couple of things. We'll start with the definitions. Let's begin. The first definition of CAPM beta. CAPM beta. So, it is basically a measure of volatility or systematic risk of a security or a portfolio in comparison to the market as a whole. Beta is a very important measure that is used as a key input of the DCF valuation. If you wish to learn DCF, you can go on and learn in the investment banking course there, in which is available in Wall Street Mojo. See, now CAPM beta formula. That's the second thing that we are going to learn, that is the formula. If you have a slightest of the hint regarding the DCF modeling, then you would have heard about the capital asset pricing model that calculates the cost of equity. Now, if you calculate the cost of equity as per the books, then you know cost of equity is equal to, you can say, the risk-free rate, that is the RF, plus you have to multiply beta into the risk premium. So this is going to be your cost of equity. Now the risk-free rate over here, you can say, I'll show you in a diagram. As you can see, the risk-free rate plus beta into risk premium, this is basically the government's rate, that is a treasury rate, the return investor expects from the completely risk-free investment, and should be current cash flow. Beta is your sensitivity. It is a function of both the business risk as well as the financial risk. Consider everything. Beta is a measure of systematic risk, which we'll study. Risk premium is basically the extra gain that you're getting because of taking the risk. Apart from the risk-free rate is your risk premium. So investing in stock market is riskier than the investing in government bond. Investor expects a higher return to induce them to take the higher risk of investing in equities. So if you have not heard about beta yet, then you need not worry. This tutorial will explain you about the beta in the most basic way. Let us take an example. When we invest in stocks, it is but human to pick stocks that have highest possible returns. However, if one chases only returns, then the other risk corresponding elements is missed. That is, we are talking about over here is risk. So, actually, every stock is expected to have two types of risk. One is non-systematic risk, and another is systematic risk. We'll discuss both of them. Non-systematic risk includes a risk that is specific to company or industry. This kind of risk can be eliminated through diversification. And you can say this across the sectors and companies, the effect of the diversification is that the diversifiable risk of the various equities can offset each other. Systematic risk are those risks that affects the overall stock market. Systematic risk cannot be mitigated through diversification, but can be well understood via an important risk measure that is called as beta, which we just learned. So now what is beta? Beta definition. Beta is a measure of the stock risk in relation to the overall market. As you can see over here in the diagram, return on the stock over the risk-free return. Beta 2.0, this is 1. Below that is 0.5. And this is the risk of the market over the risk-free rate. So this is higher beta is higher risk. And lower beta is lower risk. This is in the indifference point. Beta 1 over here of the stock is the one that has the same level of the risk and the stock market. Hence, if the stock market NASDAQ or NYC rises up by 1%, then the stock price will also move by 1%. The stock price will and if the stock market moves down by 1%, the stock price will also move down by 1%. So market and stock price will also vary in this case. If the beta is greater than 1, that is 2 over here, if the beta of the stock is greater than 1, then it implies that the higher level of risk and volatility as compared to the stock market. Though the direction of the stock price changes will be same, however, the stock price movements will be greater than the extremes. Like for example, assume that the beta of, let's say there is an ABC stock is 2 over here. Then if the stock market moves up by, let's say 1%, let's say it goes up by 1%, then the stock price of ABC will move by 2% higher. That is, 2 is the beta. So the stock price of ABC will move by the 2%. Higher returns in the risk market. However, if the stock price moves down by 1%, the stock price of ABC will move down by 2%, thereby signifying higher downside risk as well. If the beta is greater than 0 and less than 1, that is, beta is 0.5, if the beta of the stock is less than 1 and greater than 0, it implies that the stock price will move with the overall market. However, the stock price will remain less risky and volatile. Like, for example, if the beta of the stock of XYZ is 0.5, it means that the overall market moves up or down by 1%, XYZ price will show an increase or decrease in by 0.5%.